Hi guys, today we'll talk about limitations of the marine sextant and how they can be addressed. Although the sextant is the most reliable instrument available on board, it is however given to a few limitations like anything else. The limitations on the use of the marine sextant fall into following four groups. The first one is obscurity of the sea horizon, which may be caused due to haze or fog or mist. Fog, mist or haze may obscure the horizon to the extent where it becomes impossible to take a sight. In other cases, the obscurity may only be slight. When this is the case, it may be possible to obtain better results by taking sights from a lower level than normal. When this is done, the distance to the sea horizon will be shortened and thus a clear horizon may be obtained. The second one is illumination of the sea horizon. Except for possibly one or two nights either side of full moon, the horizon may not be visible for long after sunset nor for long before sunrise. On a moonless night, the horizon is generally not visible when the sun is more than 9 degrees below the horizon. On the other hand, darkness is very necessary for stars to be visible. And apart from very bright stars and certain planets, stars are seldom visible unless the sun is about 3 degrees below the horizon. In general, therefore, star observations are confined on moonless nights to a short period around the time at which the sun is 6 degrees below the horizon. The third limitation falls under obscurity of the body. The sun may sometimes be sighted through thin cloud, but the shape and size may be distorted, and it may then be necessary to bisect the disk with the horizon. An alternative trick is to deftly turning the telescope and concentrate on the sun's image. In many instances, sextant observations are completely prevented by the presence of clouds. The slide here shows that sometimes hazy skies can distort the celestial body. In these cases, the sun may be partially obscured or distorted. Use of the filters may assist in producing a pure image, as shown in the slides here. The fourth limitation refers to either very small altitudes or very high altitudes. At altitudes of less than 10 to 15 degrees, there will be larger refraction suffered by the light rays traveling from the celestial body to the Earth, and the observed angles may be less reliable than otherwise. Such observations should, as far as possible, be avoided. In cases of very high altitudes, for near 90 degrees, stand back to back with another observer, each looking either north or south. One will be taking an altitude less than 90 degrees and the other an altitude more than 90 degrees. The smaller will be the correct value. This ends the presentation today for sextant limitations and how they can be addressed. I hope this was useful to you. Thank you.